In this video, I want to introduce you Ethernet-APL. In addition, we will discuss which products and solutions Beckhoff offers for this technology. But before we start with the technical details, let's take a step back. Why do we need a new communication technology for the process industry? So let us imagine a classic process plant. We have long and full cable runs. We need to ensure the explosion protection. We have to reduce the downtime and increase the plant availability. And we do that by monitoring and diagnostics all over our plant. Especially for this point, more data is needed. Data volumes that can't be transferred with the current structures, with the current technologies in the process industry. So, for this reason, the Ethernet Advanced Physical Layer has been developed. It is based on two standards. On the one hand, we have the Ethernet standard, which is, which designs or describes the communication part of that. It is designed for 10 Mbit per second communication speed over one pair of cable and up to 1 kilometer cable length. On the other side, we have the power supply over the same pair of wires. It ensures the explosion protection of that field device. The communication of both of these standards are a solution for all the problems that I just mentioned, which occur in the process industry. So let's take a look at the typical Ethernet-APL architecture. We have a power switch, which is designed to combine the external feeding, so the power, and the standard Ethernet network of your process plant. And under that, we have the field switches. These are designed to connect to all the field devices and connect them into the higher level systems. So with these field devices and the Ethernet-APL communication standard, we can integrate all of our products and all the field devices up into zone zero of the process plant, up into zone zero of the hazardous areas. But all of that is just a vision right now. The reality looks different, or the current status looks different. We have a standard Ethernet backbone with no power switch included. We just use the field switches, connect them directly into the Ethernet backbone, and feed them externally. So, as a requirement for that, for this architecture, all the field devices need to be APL capable. But this is not the case right now in the process industry. The reality looks different for that. We do not have enough field devices which are APL capable to, or we do not have them on the market right now to spread APL all over the current plant or all over new plants. In addition, really simple digital inputs, for example, won't be converted into Ethernet APL because it does not make any sense to convert them because we do not have any more data than just digital input. So in all this, in this field switch architecture, these signals just fall aside. So what is the idea from Beckhoff? How do we change or how do we challenge these requirements? We therefore take a different modular and more flexible approach. Our development therefore is based on the ELX series, our ELX portfolio, which is designed for the energetically safe applications. We combine the know-how in explosion protection and combine it with a Profinet controller and the corresponding connection, so the Ethernet PHY for the single pair Ethernet. And as a result, we have the ELX 6233. The ELX 6233, as shown here, joins the well-known EtherCAT portfolio from Beckhoff. It has two APL channels, and of course, it's also XE, so it's according to the presented 2Y standard for the explosion protection zones, intrinsically safe applications. But what advantages does this terminal offer you as an integrator or operator? Of course, you can combine it with different EtherCAT terminals. And because of that, you can combine it with hard protocol terminals, with digital inputs, digital outputs, and so on. So all the other well-known EtherCAT terminals from Beckhoff are able to connect to this terminal. And as shown here, we can also connect an CX and computer in front of that EtherCAT terminal string to cover gateway or edge device applications. In addition to EtherCAT, other protocols such as OPC-UA or Profinet can be covered by installing a controller, for example. But what else do we have in terms of benefits for you? So of course, like I said, we are compliant to the two-way standard and therefore can connect to, field devices out of zone zero of the, hazardous areas. And we are really compact. And because of that, we can be flexible, mounted inside of an existing cabinet, or we can be used for like test setups, for example. And because of EtherCAT in the backbone, we have a much smaller process image of all the data we got, and because of that, have a faster communication speed. And of course, because of the controller, the Profinet controller inside of the terminal, we can run like security functions inside of that, because we have the controller on the terminal. So back to the beginning. We looked at the architecture of an Ethernet-APL plant and that there are many signals which can't be covered or can't be connected to this architecture. Or you need to have a whole bunch of other remote IOs to combine Ethernet-APL and existing standards in different like cabinets, for example. So how does the solution with our ELX6233 look like? We have a compact integration of all the technologies which I presented, like HART, like Profinet, and so on. And you benefit from all these technologies, of course. And you have additional advantages in terms of security, speed, expandability, cost, space, and so on, because of this just little small terminal. As presented, we can also integrate a CX industry computer inside of this terminal, inside of this terminal string, and simple implement like a more open architecture, for example, with that. So the data is pre-processed and mapped and then provided via OPCA, for example. So this brings us to the end of this overview on Ethernet-APL. So what do you take away? APL has the potential to shape the future of process automation. But, however, there are some challenges to overcome, especially with regards on communication in existing plants. The ELX6233 supports you with these exactly problems and also create further possibilities in, for example, the keyword NOAA. So please do not hesitate to contact us if you have any further questions.